I've never been one much to go out of doors. I fashion myself a high-functioning hermit. If you need proof, you can just ask my friends. And if I had friends, they would surely confirm it.
I'd never been out of my home in Bemidji. I always considered it not worth the risk. But work shipped me off to that way too big apple, a place far too packed with a pace much too brisk.
A curmudgeon who never would leave lest he had
and
to.
And a frittering fretful just forced out of town. We weren't supposed to meet in our lifetimes.
But did.
And this is the story of how it went down.
New York was normal. Well, normal as ever.
At first, it seemed only a few were infirmed.
But so much can change in just one New York minute.
When suddenly, 500 cases confirmed.
The CDC issued its recommendations.
Quarantine. And a full 6 feet of distance. Back home in Bemidji, that wasn't an issue.
But in New York City, you meet some resistance. Imagine yourself stuck in midtown Manhattan.
Huge hordes of humans preparing for plague.
I knew that supplies would soon be depleted.
I gathered my courage and my shopping bag.
When screaming and panic, disaster en masse. Everyone looking to save their own ass.
Rolls of TP rolling off the shelves. Everyone thinking of only themselves.
Customers swapping their germs in the aisles, then touching their faces. How nasty, how vile.
And not that we want to make this a polemic, but don't go to Duane Reade in a global pandemic.
I was looking for something to sanitize with.
And that's when the two of us first locked eyes with the very last bottle of Purell Advanced Hand Sanitizing Soothing Gel with Triple Action Moisturizer.
Sorry there, lady, but I saw it first. When a person calls dibs, it just can't be reversed.
Buddy, there's no way in H-E-L-L you're taking the very last thing of Purell.
I've got to have it. Without it, I'll panic. Hole up in my home, I'll drive myself manic. I'll fall into fits of hyperventilation, succumbing to a bout of asphyxiation.
But you must understand why I feel so wary. I spent my whole life being an actuary. I crunched all the numbers, and yes, I'm expectant. I will literally die without this disinfectant.
So if one of us takes this, the other's in danger? Could I really do that to this beautiful stranger?
I propose that we just share the bottle to start, so long as we always keep 6 feet apart.
It was clear there was no other way left to see it. Well, if that's how it is,
then so germaphobe be it.
So through Central Park, on we walked with great speed. I 6 feet ahead and her 6 feet behind.
And what's that you say? Why not take the train? Excuse me, are you quite out of your mind?
The subway is
filthy. It's full of contagions. I'd much rather crisscross all over Manhattan than wallow the while in a whole city's microbes.
And sit in a train car some hobo has shat in?
With time of the essence and the bottle to share, we fled to his loft on the Upper West Side.
And before you suggest I'm some Don Juan asshole, we kept those 6 feet even holed up inside. Thank you.
rinse, lather, repeat. And repeat, and repeat. We each washed our hands for well over an hour.
We soaked the Purell bottle in the Purell and fought over who got to take the first shower. I was insistent on doing the dishes, so she got to work disinfecting my soap.
And how do you disinfect a disinfectant? With more disinfectant, some moxie, and hope.
Whoever thought I'd meet someone so anal? Here's to my germaphobe partner in crime.
We both raised our glasses, but clinked them? No way. We kept up the distance, 6 feet at all times.
It was, in a way, like an elegant waltz. I'd step two toward the kitchen.
And I'd two away. I'd reach across the couch to turn on the TV.
And I'd counter by turning the opposite way. Always 6 feet, by our mutual insistence. As hours turned to days, so we found our routine.
Thank you.
as weeks turned to months, still we stayed at our distance and hunkered on in through a long quarantine.
Meanwhile, the newscasts were growing despairing.
We tuned in to see a whole world run amok. The streets were all empty, the city a ghost town.
Everything totally fucked.
Language!
New York was eerie, completely deserted. Theaters and stadiums specially struck. And I'm no sports fan, but I was converted. Everything's totally...
Not again!
Sucked.
I realized that under his crusty persona, he just couldn't cope with New York and airsats.
Never thought that I would, but I miss all the people. The food and the culture. I even miss cats. I started to tear up. To hide it, I blinked.
I reached out to comfort him, just didn't think.
6 feet!
I'm sorry.
I can't deal with this stress!
He went back to his room, and I curled up in mine. Not 6 feet of distance, now quite in excess. I'm sorry, not sorry. I let myself slip and drew my hand near to your panicking face. But if you can't let someone into your bubble, then what is the point of your personal space?
My cell phone was buzzing. I hate that loud buzzing. They make too much noise and they cause too much cancer. But then when I saw it was her who kept calling, I figured I maybe should pick up and answer. Hey.
Hey is for horses. It was more than the germs that he found oh so gross. He'd never let anyone awfully close.
I'd reacted too harshly. Now I couldn't fight it. The knowledge my feelings for her were requited. Look, I'm no fool. You're a pandemic dream, but all of this is new for me.
Oh, sweetie, I know, but long as we're in the apocalypse together...
I'm with you, but could we please just take it slow?
By day, we acted like nothing had changed. The end of the world we'd platonically share. But everything shifted as soon as night came when, from separate rooms, we began our affair.
On Facebook, we poked, slid into DMs. Across every platform, we liked and we friended. We figured out FaceTime, Skype, Zoom, and LinkedIn.
And sent Snapchats exactly how they were intended.
And for once, social media brought people together.
Hey!
Hey is for horses. May I have this dance?
I pretended to place both my hands on his shoulders.
And I stretched out my arms, though not quite to her side. I followed her lead as she swayed on my screen.
And for once, I imagined that we were outside, Called what I'd heard as a kid at school dances. The chaperones watching the teen sucking face cried, "Leave room for Jesus."
That's weird.
So I know, but I doubt even Jesus needs quite this much space.
Still, with creativity and some persistence, we grew close despite over 6 feet of distance.
The newscasters said this would be a Gomorrah. The months rolled right by, and we braced for that Sodom. For ages, we thought there would be no tomorrow, but the docs looked for cures and eventually got them.
The news was emphatic. So, just go outdoors. They'd turned on a dime, but I was apoplectic. How could the whole world become asymptomatic? I still had 2 years worth left of prime antiseptic. There's no way I'm going to leave now, because my quarantine won't end till I say it does. I think we better stay in, just in case.
For how long?
Oh, just till the calm has subsided.
But what would we do then, and where would we go?
I don't know. There's still so much that's undecided. These times in the bunker have gotten me through what I was so sure was the end of my life. And now that we need no more 6 feet of distance, I'm finally ready to make you my wife.
Oh, okay.
But I missed all the echoing doubt. Some distances cannot be measured in feet. They cannot be bridged because they're just too damn far. What's wrong?
Well, it's just... there are too many risks. Actuarially speaking, I can't be your wife. Please don't make me list all the oopses and gotchas we'd be signing up for the rest of our life. And if we did last, what would we leave behind? We'd see quarantined toddlers become quarantines. In a world where disasters just happen like clockwork, to subject them to that, the idea is obscene.
We'd know how to protect them. We're both paranoiacs.
Yes, I admit that we make quite a pair, but we can't disinfect the whole world of its awful. And you can't measure up to my endless despair. Our relationship lasted up here in the bunker, but you needed that bond to have 6 feet of distance. Could we ever have love built on closeness together if you couldn't when facing the end of existence? Statistically, couples cannot thrive on fear. So our fear, I'm afraid, has me full of misgivings. I could live with you when I was sure we would die, but I can't live with you if we've got to keep living.
She was over the threshold, then over 6 feet, then beyond any distance that I could make up. I thought about chasing her, tearing down Broadway, and sometimes I do. Then I wake up. Time was a daze in those days she was here. Well, the next days were doozies once she had departed. Just disinfectant for company now. I thought back to how our relationship started. One panic day before lockdown was called. Two strangers, by chance, in a Duane Reade just met. Could there be a more beautiful start? Was no less, I think, than what they call kismet. 99.99% of bacteria killed by this bottle, and I remember she went.
Sure, that's all swell, fine, and dandy, I guess, but what of the other 0.01%?
I must get them all. But I took it too far. When you scrub your whole world, well, sometimes the price is you scrub away things that you wish you had kept. Like the data I scrubbed off all my devices. So I sat at my landline, determined, but lost. She'd mentioned Bemidji, but never her name. So I pored through the phone books, desperate to find her, but everyone's answer was always the same. Hello? Is this her?
No, this is Sarah Ann.
Hello, is this her?
No, this is Amy Flan.
I had only hope, with no guide, no plan. Hello, is this her?
No, this is Emma Reed.
Hello, is this her?
No, this is Larkin Sneed.
This was becoming a trial, indeed. Hello, is this her?
No, this is Sally West.
Hello, is this her?
No, this is Mary Best.
No luck so far. So, I called up the rest. Hello, is this her?
Oh, this is Alice Flanagan.
Hello? Is this her?
No! You've reached Gwendolyn Drumgoolin Steinenberg.
I was quite up to here with these shenanigans. Hello, is this her?
No, you've reached Amy Flan again.
I I didn't find her. I called every number multiple times, but it didn't pan out. I'd long since run out of all hope, cheer, and joy when my 2 years worth of disinfectant ran out. I went back to Dwayne Reed, and what in the hell?
I was standing right there, right beside the Purell. I realized I let my fear make me a fool. I lost all my senses, including direction. I tried to, but couldn't get back to his loft when I couldn't remember the darned intersection. I buzzed every buzzer of every apartment all over the Big Apple's Upper West Side, sanitizing my hands in between every button, my knuckles all chafed with each squirt I applied. Buzzer one. No. This was no fun. Buzzer two? No. What was I to do? Buzzer three? No. Would it ever be he? Buzzer four? No. So I tried a few more. Buzzer five, 1,800,010.
Well, we don't need to go through this whole shtick again.
I thought, were we ever to meet face to face, the only hope was in the very first place. That store where we met amid Doomsday's stampede, aisle six, cleaning products, in our own Dwayne Reed. So it wasn't completely by chance. I came every day to that aisle, hopeful and expectant that one day he'd be ready to rejoin the world and we'd be reunited by more disinfectant.
2 whole years had passed. And then, to my surprise,
the two of us finally once more locked eyes with another bottle of Purell Advanced Hand Sanitizing Soothing Gel with Triple Action Moisturizer.
And, if I might add, an industrial size.
Labeled half off. Now, that's quite a steal. But after he dropped it inside of his cart,
we ran towards each other with wide open arms.
No more fear or pandemics to keep us apart.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey is for horses. No longer needing the 6 feet of distance.
Both of us ready for real coexistence. Your parents have never much loved the outdoors. We fashion ourselves as a family of hermits.
And so, Quarantina, and so, Quarantim, that's the story of us, Helmy and Hermit.
So no need to fret monsters under your bed. Good night, little munchkins, now sleep without fear. The world is so full of such terrible horribles, you really are both so much safer in here.
And what's that you say? Why haven't we used the tub of Purell in industrial size? Well, we keep it on our kitchen table because we like to remember how we first locked eyes.
Oh, you're such a sweetheart. But also, you're wrong. We like to remember. Is that really true?
Oh, no, not again. I won't arbitrate this. You want to ask them which one of us it belongs to? I bought the tub.
I saw it first. I beat you to the store.
God, you're the worst. You were there because of me.
Wait, is that relevant? How?
Well, actuary.
Let's not do this right now.
We'll just say goodnight, kids, and turn out the lights. And leave you with just a few last sweet remarks.
We'll plug in the floor lamp. Remember, keep hope. There's always a small glowing light in the dark.
And if you get scared and you have a bad dream
about oopses and gotchas and frightening old fears,
like the spiders you eat in your sleep every year, or global pandemics, or swift climate change,
or howling tornadoes not quite out of range, or all the lead paint on the swings where you play,
or stock markets crashing your 401k, or sinking in quicksand, or sinking in doubt,
or small confined spaces where you'll never get out, or earthquakes that register 10 on the Richter,
getting eaten alive by a boa constrictor, or being stark naked while speaking in public,
or the steady collapse of the U.S. Republic, or that nagging feeling that blankets all moments,
that crippling loneliness deep in your gut that you try to dismiss, but you never quite can because it's the certainty way deep on down that you're completely alone each and every day.
Or, gosh, what was it we're trying to say?
All these fears are valid. They're part of existence, but you can't live your whole life consumed by your fears.
You've just got to trust us. Believe our insistence that Mommy and Daddy will always be here.
Until one of us dies. But till that day...
If you need us, just call. We'll be right on our way.
Because we're just across the hall.
Only 6 feet away.
Purple like wine. Purple like wine. There was a time.
Hey everyone, thank you so much for tuning in to 6 feet of distance apart. We hope you enjoyed it. Before we go on with the show, the rest of our SNI stream, yes, we have a ton of people to thank. It will just be a brief thank you, so stick around. Please tune in for these credits. Just a short roll of everyone who's helped us get here and put on this show. Huge thank you to everyone. Thank you to Impact, Sunny 97.7, Sweet and Easy Events, Electric Press. You'll see that now. And we'll be right back to go live and bring you the rest of the stream. Week of Love, SNI, week 6.
Right after the credits.
See you.
Stay tuned.
Woo! I did the crowd.